Hello, everybody. Hello, everyone, and welcome back again to my channel. I hope you're doing well and doing great and excellent, as I am doing as well. For today's video, we're going to talk about the common NCLEX laboratory values that we must know and we need to understand, and we need it by heart because they are very important and they always ask questions about it. So on this video, we're going to talk about the normal values and if they increase and if they decrease, what would happen and their indications. Without further ado, let's start. Okay, first is the hemoglobin. Now remember, hemoglobin is a precursor, or it carries oxygen and precursor for development of that is in the erythrocytes or your red blood cell. Okay, now hemoglobin differs from male to female. From male is 14 to 16.5 or 14 to 17 is okay grams per deciliter. And for female is 12 to 15 grams per deciliter. Okay, now what would happen if they increased? Now this would cause you to have polycythemia vera, or increase production of the red blood cell, and then your blood get thicker. Okay, and also they are caused by dehydration. So increasing the portion of the red blood cell, that is for hemoglobin. However, if that decrease, then it will lead to anemia because less oxygenation from the hemoglobin would lead to anemia. Okay, check on that. Next is hematocrit. Now, hematocrit is a portion of the cell, the blood cell. It's almost the same as a function of your, of the hemoglobin, because the red blood cell, when they are all together, that is the hematocrit, okay? Now, for male, it's 41 to 51%. Check on that. And for female, it's 36 to 46%. Okay, now if that would decrease, hematocrit will decrease, will lead to dehydration as well. And then if that would decrease, of course, anemia, or either for decrease, if that is for decrease, will lead also to leukemia due to long-term illness. So it means like your bone marrow keep producing red blood cell, but it's not functional. Okay, next, moving on to WBC, or the white blood cell, or what we call the leukocytes. Now the normal value is 5,000 to 10,000 cubic millimeter. Okay, cubic millimeter. Okay, now when this increases, when WBC increases, it indicates there is inflammatory reaction. So they keep sending WBC to a certain injury. Okay, now, however, if that would decrease, that would lead to risk for infection. So it means that there is decreased production of your WBC and the infection is going on and going on. Now, the term for increase WBC is leukocytosis, while for decrease is leukopenia. Okay, leukopenia. Okay, next is your platelets. Now, platelets are responsible for clotting and thereby preventing bleeding. Okay, now the normal value is 150,000 to 450,000 unit per liter. Okay, if this would increase, is due to a certain illness or infection that is going on, where in your bone marrow keep producing in response to a certain injury. That's for homeostasis, and that is called thrombocytosis. Okay, increase platelets. Now the more serious is if the platelets going down, then therefore your risk for bleeding. So you, especially if the platelets are very low, like 10,000, that is risky. So you will bleed on your eyes, nose, ears, okay? And the internal organs are bleeding. So that's called thrombocytopenia. check on that. Remember that. Next, moving on to INR, or the International Normalized Ratio. Ratio, is 1 to 2, especially if those are people taking warfarin, okay? Now, if that would increase the INR, therefore, your risk for bleeding. It means that your platelets are longer to clot, or longer time to clot, to clump, and create create something that seal the bleeding, and because of that, your risk for bleeding. Okay, if that would decrease INR, it would lead to blood clotting. So it means it easily coagulate easily. So the platelets or the blood cells clump easily. And that is also dangerous, because if this clot are dislodged, the thrombus might move and will clot into your brain. So that's for INR, okay? Moving on, let's move to PT, or the prothrombin time is 10 to 14 seconds. Okay, remember that. If that would increase more than that, too long to clot, that will lead to bleeding. Either the person has a vitamin K deficiency or a liver disease problem, okay? If that would decrease, okay, the blood form clot easily, as I have discussed with the INR, okay? So it's the same. Next is the APTT, or activated partial thromboplastin time, especially for those persons who are taking heparin. Okay, remember that. So that's 30 to 40 seconds. That's a normal value. It's the same. Bleeding occur if that would increase, the clot taking longer to form. So it means it cannot clot easily, or it cannot coagulate easily. So therefore, your risk for bleeding. Okay, then if that would decrease, there is a coagulation problem or deficiency. So that's why the blood is very thin. So you might find that you have like bruises everywhere on your body. Okay, and that would decrease. Remember that, okay? Next, let's talk about the AST, or the ESCOT. The AST stands for aspartate aminotransferase. And the ESGOT is serum glutamic oxalotransaminase. So these are important in the muscle of your internal organs, specifically your heart, your brain, your kidney, and then your liver, okay? So the normal is 10 to 40 international unit per liter. So if this would increase, it indicates that there is a liver damage, heart damage, brain, or kidney damage, okay? So they check on that. Remember, 10 to 40 for AST, or the ESCOT. If that would decrease, you're okay, you're fine, you're doing good, okay? Good on that, okay? Now, the other one is the ALT, or the alanine aminotransferase, or the SGPT, or the serum glutamic pyruvic transaminase, specifically for liver damage or the heart, okay? So 5 to 35, this would increase specifically if there are liver or heart damage or your myocardial infarction, okay? If decrease, you're okay too. Good on that. Okay, moving on to your BUN, or the blood urea and nitrogen, and as well as the creatinine. Okay, let's start first with the BUN. Now, the BUN is 8 to 25 milligrams per deciliter, okay? Increase of this value, of course, would lead to kidney damage. So it assesses your kidney, okay? Kidney function. Now, decreasing BUN is due to malnutrition or low protein intake, okay? Or wasting of muscle, okay? So that is for BUN. For creatinine, clearance and BUN, the creatinine is 0.6 to 1.3 milligrams per deciliter. The normal value for creatinine is 0.6 to 1.3 milligrams per deciliter. It also indicates if that is increased kidney damage, if that would decrease is due to malnutrition and low protein as well, okay? So I hope you got it, okay? Then let's move to another. Okay, glucose, of course, the normal glucose level is 70 to 110 milligrams per deciliter. Now, increase of this, of course, is hyperglycemia in the blood or increased blood glucose in the blood. So we will tackle this on endocrine or studying the diabetes mellitus, and decreasing of your glucose is hypoglycemia, okay? Next is the carbon dioxide. Remember, carbon dioxide is an acid. So therefore, if that would increase, would lead to something dangerous to our body and to your brain and to your heart and to other parts of your body. Now, the normal carbon dioxide is 22 to 32 milliequivalent per liter. Now, carbon dioxide, if that increase, either you are having hypoventilation, so your carbon dioxide is trapped in the lungs, so it cannot be eliminated, then therefore you would have respiratory acidosis, or either a lung disease wherein the air are trapped on your lungs, such as your emphysema, such as your tuberculosis. So those who have chronic obstructive pulmonary disease, so they are having hypoventilation and they are respiratory acidosis. Okay, then if that would decrease carbon dioxide due to kidney diseases, or either you are having a diabetic ketoacidosis. Remember, the carbon dioxide is an acid, okay? Next is your potassium. Now, the potassium is 3.5 to 5 milliequivalent per liter. Remember that, 3.5 to 5 milliequivalent per liter. Increase, of course, hyperkalemia, and decrease is hypokalemia. Potassium is very important, as well as with the sodium, so they are always balanced. If potassium is in, and then your sodium out, so that balances with that, so it doesn't stay together, okay? Now, next is the sodium, or your very important sodium is 135 to 145 milliequivalent per liter. Increase of that is hypernatremia, and decrease is hyponatremia, okay? This is very important in your fluid and electrolytes, okay? Calcium is very important in bone and synthesis and heart contraction, okay? Is equivalent to 8.5 to 10.5 milliequivalent per liter. Anything that would decrease and increase, of course, if that would increase as hypercalcemia, if that would decrease, and that is hypocalcemia. Hypocalcemia throws a sign like you're having carpopedal spasm or weakness. Hypercalcemia is that your bone gets brittle, okay? Next is magnesium. Magnesium is 1.6 to 2.6 milliequivalent per liter. Then increases hypermagnesemia and decreases hypomagnesemia. We're going to tackle the signs and symptoms on the fluid and electrolytes, okay? Chloride is 95 to 100 5 milliequivalent per liter. Of course, increase is hyperchloremia. It means that you are having dehydration and then, or lack of water, and then decrease is hypochloremia due to fluid loss, such as nausea and vomiting, or diarrhea. So that's what's hypochloremia. So that's for laboratory, okay? To summarize, I have told you that these are the normal values. So you would have your hemoglobin is for male and females 14 to 16.5, for females 12 to 15 grams per deciliter. Hematocrit is 41 to 51% for male, and for females, 36 to 46%. Normal WBC is 5,000 to 10,000. Platelets is 150 to 450 unit per liter. INR is 1 to 2. You have to memorize, you have to know it by heart. PT is 10 to 14 seconds. APT is 30 to 40 seconds. SGOT or AST is 10 to 40. ALT or what we call the SGPT is 5 to 35. BUN is 8 to 25 milligrams per deciliter. Creatinine is 0.6 to 1.3. Glucose is 70 to 110 milligrams per deciliter. CO2 is 22 to 32 milliequivalent per liter. Potassium is 3.5 to 5 MEQ. Sodium is 135 to 145. Calcium is 8.5 to 10.5 milliequivalent per liter. Magnesium is 1.6 to 2.6. And chloride is 95 to 105 milliequivalent per liter. Know your love values and you will love NCLEX. Okay? So you will have a great journey when you're able to memorize and know it by heart. Okay? What I do is sometimes I write it down, okay? So you write all the love and then together with the normal values. Don't forget that, and then write it again like multiple times so you will memorize it and know it by heart. This would help you a lot. Thank you. Have a nice day and God bless you for watching this video. Hope you learn and goodbye.